It's back to the future as the government revives the contentious three strikes law, vowing to get tough on serious, violent and sexual offenders. While there'll be tweaks, there are concerns the move's more about posturing than delivering actual results. And as political editor Mikey Sherman reports, it'll come at a cost.
The coalition government getting tough on crime.
Our goal here is to incarcerate violent offenders. I don't care whether they're Māori or non-Māori, they're coming off our streets. I make no apologies for putting in place this legislation because I think it's really important.
But it's not a new policy, rather a political tug of war. National introduced it in 2010, Labor scrapped it in 2022, only for Christopher Luxon and the ACT Party to revive it once more.
And that's getting serious, repetitive, recidivist, violent and sexual offenders off our streets and behind the bars.
But many argue it doesn't work.
I don't think you're going to come across a defendant who stops and thinks, wait, if I commit this crime, I'm going to be liable for a third strike.
The new revised legislation adding strangulation and suffocation to the offence list, while also offering a sentence discount of up to 20% for some early guilty pleas. The law will also only apply to sentences of more than 2 years after it was found some lower level offenders were getting unfairly caught up under the law.
Some cases came to be highlighted.
It's not good policy, ultimately, there's no evidence to suggest that it actually reduces violent offending.
In 2018, a Justice Ministry report found that in the 8 years the law had been in force, it was having no obvious effects in reducing serious crimes.
Well, we've seen different pieces of advice. There's been advice from previous examples of where, you know, when we had it before, and likewise we've even seen examples from overseas jurisdictions like
California. And does that advice specifically say that this will lead to a reduction in crime?
Advice that I've seen is that over the last 5 years we've had over a 30% increase in serious violent crime in New Zealand.
The legislation is expected to capture between 45 and 90 extra prisoners each year at a cost of $11 million annually, a price the Prime Minister says is worth it in the interests of protecting victims.
We think we will be compliant with BORA and also with international human rights obligations, but that'll ultimately be a decision for the Attorney-General to see when legislation comes to the House.
Legislation that'll be sure to spark plenty of debate. Mikey Sherman, One News.